We now know that all extant living creatures derive from a single common ancestor called the Last Universal Common Ancestor. It's hard to think of a more unifying view of life. All living things are linked to a single-celled creature, the deepest root to the complex branching tree of life. If we could play the movie of life backward, we would find this microscopic primogenitor at the starting point of biological evolution, the sole actor in what would become a very dramatic story, lasting some 3.5 billion years, leading to us. What made us human? Beginning 1.5 million years ago with Homo erectus, a more efficient way to obtain and ingest more calories in less time, cooking, led to the rapid acquisition of a huge number of neurons in the still fairly small cerebral cortex, the part of the brain responsible for finding patterns, reasoning, developing technology, and passing it on through culture. The human brain, a primate organ of the mind, owes its cognitive abilities to the enormous number and connectivity of neurons in the cerebral cortex, namely the neocortex. It's not the size of our brain that matters, but the fact that we have a large number of more optimally connected neurons in our neocortex than any other primate. A proper understanding of evolution reveals humankind in its glorious uniqueness that compounded over time. One foot planted firmly among all of the creatures we've evolved alongside, and the other in the special place of conscious self-awareness and understanding of higher purpose that we now occupy in the grand scheme of things. At times, it may seem as if the entire prior history of the universe led us to this pivotal moment of realization that we are the brain cells of a larger planetary superorganism, progressively morphing into one global mind.
Excerpt from Noogenesis, Computational Biology, by Alex V. Kulov, available now on Amazon.
Extadelic Media.